マジックカードダークコーリング発動。墓地のダークフュージョンを除外し、その効果の融合召喚を行う。
Hello everyone, Jacolo here, and welcome to Yu-Gi-Oh! Engineering, a series which will cover all engines in Yu-Gi-Oh! Eventually. Last time we got isekai'd by Dracoon and became a brave who helped provide Omni Negation. This time, however, we are turning to the dark side of dimensions in order to harness the power of demons and become the Supreme King. Yes. It's time for the Evil Hero Engine.
The Evil Heroes are a subset of regular hero monsters and were first introduced all the way back in November 2007's Gladiator's Assault. They consist of fiend monsters and have never made an impact in the world of children's card games. The deck was known by the general population since it was used by the Supreme King in the anime, and also because it's a subset of the fucking heroes. However, it never took beyond the playground deck, which would then be demolished by a simple breeze at the locals. Everything changed with the release of Legendary Duelist Immortal Destiny in September 2019. That set introduced a new wave of support for evil hero monsters, and by extension, the evil hero engine. The engine was almost immediately utilized, however, it was solely used in hero decks. The first documented placement of this engine was about 2 months later in Brooklyn, New York, where Pavel Arizaga made the top 4 cuts in the regional tournament, utilizing that engine. Afterward, it would pop up at YCS Milan a month later, getting into top 64 piloted by Sebastian Hochfellner, and various regional tops all around the world at the beginning of 2020. After that, there's no further information regarding the engine's usage, which is unfortunate. However, I still believe it is utilized and it will be used to even greater extent further down the line.
The engine, as it became somewhat of a tradition for this series, is very straightforward. It's made out of 3 cards, which we are going to look at right now. This is the starter for the engine. It's such as a card that is either named Dark Fusion or unless it's in the card text. That's the only effect that you'll have to be worried of. The fact it can't attack unless there is a fusion monster is irrelevant. Falling is the card most likely to be searched thanks to a Dusted Gold's effect. It allows the user to fusion summon an evil hero fusion monster by banishing materials listed on it from the graveyard. Miracle Fusion style!
Malicious Bane is the payout for using this engine. It's a big monster that cannot be destroyed by any means, but it can destroy other monsters and gain attack afterwards. It does prevent your non-hero monster from attacking though, but it's not a big deal, since it does pack a punch.
The build, at least the one used in competitive environment, played one of each card mentioned. Since it's a very small engine, it's a very decent addition to various decks. Additionally, getting a very big monster with a powerful effect for basically no cost means for a very big plus. The engine also works perfectly with Destroyer Phoenix Enforcer, since Malicious Bane cannot be destroyed by card effect, giving you an option to blow it up or try, so you don't lose any card advantage. To be perfectly honest, there's very little that I was able to find when it comes to the cons of this engine. Biggest one I could think of is Malicious Bane preventing non-hero monsters from attacking, limiting your options to deal damage to the opponent. When it comes to usage, Hero is the most obvious choice. If not used in those, anything that can splash, destroy Phoenix Enforcer can also try and make a room for this engine for additional advantage. When it comes to the price of this engine, this is a little awkward, since the original printing of this engine was in Legendary Duelist Immortal Destiny, and if you were to get copies from that set, the cost would be about $180 for the entire engine at the time of recording. However, Adusted Gold and Malicious Bane are in Brothers of Legend booster sets, so copies from there should be available shortly on the American market. The Europeans already have those, and they go for 14 euro a piece, a rather affordable price if you ask me. As for Dark Calling, the cheapest printing is still the one from Legendary Duelist and Immortal Destiny of about $2. And with that we became evil. And if you like this little trip to the dark side and you want to join me on the next adventure, be sure to subscribe to the channel. While you're at it, remember to like and comment, and I will see you in the next one.